Hello and welcome to this and that. It says Thursday, but I'm releasing this on Friday, but you know, whatever. So this is a continuation from the Kraaft It Live that we did. Kraaft It Live is a live crafting show that we do on Tuesdays, and it's a lot of fun, but we don't always get the project done because there was tons and tons of drying and layering and all kinds of things. So I at least showed the idea of what we were going to do, and I thought it was a good stopping point, but I definitely wanted to finish so that those who had invested could see the finished part. So it is sped up four times fast because it really is just a lot of the same things. So we made this really awesome textured background. If you missed the Kraaft It Live video where we made this this booklet, or I guess it's a book cover, out of a lasagna box, you really missed a really good time, because over on Kraaft It Live, we spend the whole hour, and sometimes a little bit longer, just hanging out with friends and laughing, enjoying each other's company. And we also make some fun stuff in the process. So it's a very interactive and fun place to hang out on Tuesdays. And of course, if you can't watch it live, you can always watch the replay, and it's just as fun. And I respond to all the comments. So it's almost like, you know, you're watching it with a friend when you do that, because I always try to get in there and respond as soon as somebody leaves a comment on the replay. I've just got a makeup sponge and some black Americana paint, and I'm just going over this marabou stencil, which is just adorable. All three of the stencils that I used on this piece were marabou stencils, which their stencils are pretty cool. They've got some cute, cute cutouts, and these are more like masks, you know, because you can sort of mask the area. I don't know. It's just awesome. Anywho, so we got all that done, and I softened up some of the edges, and it's basically doodle time. And I'm going to use things like Posca pens and jelly pens and glitter pens. And there wasn't really any rhyme or reason to any of this other than to just add some marks and more details into the black. And I kind of got carried away, I guess, but isn't that the point? Like, it was just to make this cover, which we're going to be turning into an ATC booklet. And you'll see at the very end, I do sort of a flip through of the ATCs that I've collected so far. And we've started something new with the crafters community. We are doing an ATC swap. And although by the time you're watching this, the current swap has probably closed, but it doesn't mean that you can't join in on the fun for upcoming ATC swaps. So if that's something you're interested in, I suggest you sign up for our newsletter. It's a weekly newsletter. It includes an exclusive video chat, and all sorts of cool things are involved there. You get to see the incredible cartoon series from Lynn's, our resident tunist, Harry Farmer's daughter. She has graciously created a series of images called, I call them Mr. Crafter in a paint tube, and she has him in all various positions in his paint tube, advertising for the Craft Shack on the go, and it's just super cool. And it's a feature that's exclusive to the newsletter. So you're greeted by Mr. Crafter in a paint tube. You're welcomed by a video chat that is only available there. And the way that we're doing that is that video chat is only there for a week. So it's a once a week thing. It expires after 1 week, and it's the only place to get it. And the things I just, you know, do a little chat and hang out with you, and it's kind of like having coffee with a friend. It's a lot of fun. At least it's fun for me. Hopefully it's fun for you to watch. Like I said, we're just doing some doodling with gel pens and glitter pens and trying out some things that didn't work. And I found this silver pen and I fell in love with it. Like, I did everything from here on out with this silver pen because it was amazing. And I keep trying to show you like the shimmer of it, but it's not showing up on screen. And I did speed this up, and I know that it's kind of crazy to speed it up a little bit like this, but it was just the easiest way to get through this quickly because, to be honest, I really didn't think that you wanted to sit around and watch forever. And I just wrote some things that were in my heart about creating for others and how it has helped me grow. And that's something that I haven't really talked too much about. We've sort of changed our, we made some changes to our website. We've made some changes here at the Craft Shack about, what do you even call that? Like our tagline and different things. And where we were once, we used to say to help you find your crafty bone. Now we say learn, create, grow. And everything that we do from here on out is really going to focus on learn, create, and grow. We are trying to share the message of creativity. Everyone, we believe that everyone was made, was created by the Creator to be creative beings. And you have creativity within you. So that's what we are sharing. We want to learn together, create beautiful things, and grow. And that's what we're here for. So, anyway, I just thought that it would be nice to share the process of this with you. If you, like I said, if you did miss that Kraaft It Live video, we actually took a lasagna box, Stouffer's lasagna, if that matters to you, the lasagna box, and turned it into a journal cover, which in this case I'm using it sort of like a wrap around a three-ring binder, and it's one of those thin, flimsy binders, so that you can actually tuck the flaps of the binder into the lasagna box, and you'll see it at the end that once I get everything pretty well, drawn on and doodled on and everything else that I'm doing, I will I coat the surface as well, and then I'll do a walkthrough, and you'll see that there's like a that thin plastic three-ring binder has been tucked into both flaps, and it fits magically. It's just awesome. Like the lasagna box was built for it. All right, after I did some of these marks, I thought I'd grab this silver pen, and it didn't really work very well, so we're kind of done with that. And we'll take a second here to look nice and slow. I did slow it down for this section here. We're going to just pick it up and sort of move it around in the light so you can see some of that shimmery turquoise paint. That is, if you watched the Kraaft It Live show, you know what the paints are, but it is a PBO Studio Paint, a Dyna series. It is that two-tone iridescent color, and oh, just yummy. But anyway, so now we're going to put some dots on. I just really felt like there was not enough bright activity going on, so I used this, I don't know what you call this, but it's like a mark making tool. These are perfect for the jelly plate. That's what I bought them for, but I find myself using them like this. But it's almost like using the end of a pencil, like a brand new eraser. But this one has more of a rounded tip instead of a flat tip. And it's safe for the jelly plate because it's not a sharp instrument. You can, scrape away paint with it and make marks like that, and it's very, very handy. And I just use that citron green, it's very, very yellowish green paint to make those dots. And now I've just got some heavy white gesso. This is all deco art media, and a, I don't know, some kind of a, Like, they send you in the mail like those credit card offers. This is like one of them fake credit cards from the mail. Yeah. We're just gonna make some marks all over the place with it. Then do a few scrapings here and there. And I really, really like how this turned out. And I sort of, when all of this was dry, I took some varnish. I'm trying to think of the word varnish and coated it. I'll show you the varnish here in a second. I did not record varnishing it because, I mean, I'm just spreading on some clear stuff. So, through the magic of television, voila, a whole day or two later, this is what it looks like. It's very shimmery or shiny, I should say. It has a satin finish to it. Here, I'll show you the. It is satin varnish from DecoArt Media. And a big wide brush. And just, I just brushed it on all surfaces. And it actually dried pretty quick. I just let it cure before putting it together. And you can see that black, thin plastic binder has been tucked into the cover. The flaps of the cover, and then here's a walkthrough of the ATCs I've collected so far, and a pocket letter I got. My awesome friends, I love looking at this because I get to remember and think of my friends as I'm looking at this. And you just might recognize one of your pieces of art here, actually, if you've been a member of any of our swaps or partook, I don't know what the word is, participated in any of that with us, but. Anyway, we're getting ready to close out the end of this. Before I go, please, if you've enjoyed this, like and subscribe. Let me know in the comments if you enjoyed this at all, if you like these finished pieces like this. But I hope you did. So, have a crafty day, everybody, and stay tuned to see a full image at the very end here. Bye-bye.